Hello everyone, this is your Komali mam. Welcome to my channel. In this platform, I'm going to discuss and share all the tricks and chemistry in an easy way. Today's topic is Wittig reaction. Wittig reaction is a very good reaction which is helpful for the preparation of alkenes. Here, aldehydes or ketones reacts with Wittig reagent, that is phosphorus elide. To differentiate from this, I am writing as the R double dash. This is called phosphorus elide. Here what happens is, it results in the formation of alkene. Actually, this exchanges ketone or aldehyde exchanges oxygen with this part. It results in the formation of, see here, R. This R, I'm writing R, C, R dash, double bond. And it exchanges its part with this phosphorus elide part, CH, R dash. And it gets PH3P and it exchanges with this oxygen. This is called as triphenyl phosphoxide. See here, aldehydes or ketones reacts with phosphorus elide. What we are getting, students? We are getting alkenes. Let us see the mechanism. Triphenyl phosphine reacts with alkyl halides. See here, phosphorus is having a lone pair which donates to this carbon. Then this halogen goes as X minus. We get R. R, what is there? CH2 and P, PH3 plus. And it goes as X minus. Actually, phosphorus, we know that it belongs to 15th group, which can forms only 3 bonds. Here extra bonds are there. That's why it is getting the positive charge. It reacts with butyl lithium. Butyl lithium. This butyl lithium, what it do is, it abstracts the proton from this carbon and it goes as butane. Then it results in the formation of anion, and this lithium and this halogen goes as LiX. What we get, students, are CH minus and PPH3 plus. This is nothing but what? Wittig reagent. This is called as what? Wittig reagent. This Wittig reagent reacts with carbonyl compounds like aldehydes and ketones. This Wittig reagent donates this electron density to this carbon. Then shifting of electrons takes place in such a way, and this oxygen in turn donates its electron density to this triphenyl phosphine group. It results in the formation of a cyclic transition state. See here, C to this CH is donated, which is having an alkyl group, and this is having two alkyl groups. Oxygen is there. Next, PPH3. This is called as cyclic transition state. Further, it gives alkene and triphenyl phosphoxide. What we get? R, C, R dash, double bond, CHR. This is called as alkene, and triphenyl phosphoxide. Let us see some examples. When formaldehyde reacts with Wittig reagent, what is the product? Acetaldehyde reacts with Wittig reagent, what is the product? If acetone reacts with Wittig reagent, what is the product? Click on pass button and try this. Take out one book and pen. Just try the answers to this. Whether you are getting correct answer or not, just check it out. See, Wittig reagent is a very good method for the preparation of alkenes. Here we can prepare alkene directly from aldehydes and ketones with increase in the number of carbon atoms actually. What you have to do, what is the trick students? This oxygen exchange with this Wittig reagent, with this CHME group comes here. Okay, right here then CH2 double bond. What you get here? CHME. Here MECH double bond. What you have to write? CHME. Remove this oxygen and put this one. Next ME2C double bond CHME. Here what you get? PHCH double bond CHME. Here what you get? Double bond CHME. Here what we get? Double bond CHME. I hope you like this tricks, and if you like this video, please click on like. Still, if you didn't subscribe to my channel to get more tricks and to learn chemistry in an easy way, just subscribe my channel and put your comments down. Thanks for watching.